welcome back to this tutorial, or this set of tutorials on random numbers. Now in the previous tutorial, number one, we just printed a random number. Well, this time I want to actually use a variable to save my value of my random number. So I'm going to call this random1, there we go, equals random.randint, and of course we need to give it a range, so I'm going to make my range this time between 10 and 50. There we go. Okay, now so I'll just print, let's use a little bit of literal text, shall we? The random number equals random one. There we go. Okay, so let's have a little look at the structure of this. So we've got import random, really important, because that's the library call. We've got a variable name this time, we just call it random1, and that's our command of calling the random library using the randint function and giving the randint function some parameter values between 10 and 50, that's our range. And then the print statement, print the random number equals random1. Let's see if this works, shall we? Here we go. Click OK to save changes. There we go, the random number equals 10. Now if I run it again, just to double check, just, yeah, the random number equals 35. And if I run it again, random number equals 13. So it's choosing a random number every time. So let's have a look at what we got here. So I'm showing my random number code in the top part, and I'm showing my random number output. Okay, thank you very much for viewing.